A very pleasant good morning to all of you, dear children. Children, I welcome you all in today's live math class. I hope all of you have completed your homework and solved the worksheet that I had given children. Am I right? In the last class, I had asked you to solve question number 1 from exercise 5A. Okay, so we had started the new chapter, that is fraction, chapter number 5. And I had told you about the fractions. What is a fraction? Right, children? So before I continue the class today, let me remind you what I had told in the last class. Right, children? So what I had told you about the fractions? What is a fraction, children? So I had told you that a fraction is a part of a whole. Okay? A part of a whole. Suppose you have something as a whole. Okay? So I had given an example of a watermelon, am I right? So I had told you that if we have this watermelon and this is to be divided between 5 people, okay, 5 members of your family, then how could we divide, children? We can divide it by making partitions. So we can divide this watermelon into 5 equal parts, right, children? And each and every part of this watermelon is a fraction of it. Okay, so we have divided this into 5 equal parts. So if each part will be the 5th part of the watermelon, right? This I had told. And suppose you have got 5th part 1 times, okay, one of this 5th part, then your part will be 1/5, right, children? 1/5. And 1/5, it means you have got 1 out of 5 parts, right? So your part will be 1 out of 5, right? And in mathematics, it can be written as 1/5, right? So this 1/5 is what, children? This is a fraction. So this is a small part of the whole. So part of a whole is known as fractions. If you are getting 2 parts out of these 5 partitions, suppose 1 parts and 2 parts, right, children? Then your part will be 2 out of 5. Okay. So you will say that you have got 2/5 of the whole. So your fractional number will be 2/5. Okay, so this is your fraction number 2/5, and in the form of fraction you can write it as how, children? You can write it as 2/5, am I right? So 2/5 is what? This is a fraction. Clear? Now, children, after that I had told you how to represent the fractions on the number line, right? I think it was clear to you. So I had told you that if we have to represent some fraction on number line, then we will draw a line starting from 0. On this number line, we will put arrow on other side and we will not show the negative part of the number line because fractions are positive. Okay, so fractions don't have any negative part. So we will show only positive directions. And this number line has infinite length. Okay, we cannot show the whole number line. So we will take a small part of this number line. That means we will take a small line segment. Okay, and we will consider this whole line segment as a whole. Okay, now if I ask you to show the 3/5 of this number line, okay, 3/5 on this number line, then how could you show, children? 3/5. So 3/5, it means we have to choose 3 parts out of 5 parts, right? So we will make how many partitions, children? Here the lower part of the fraction shows the total number of partitions, right? And the upper part shows the number of partitions chosen by us, number of parts given to us. Lower part of the fraction is known as what, children? This is known as denominator, right? And the upper part of the fraction, the upper part of the fraction is known as numerator. Am I right, children? So this is numerator. So, children, so numerator and denominator. Denominator tells us about the total number of partitions we have made, and numerator tells us how many parts we have chosen for us. Okay? So children, on number line, if we have to show 3 by 5, then total how many partitions we will make, children? We will make total 5 partitions, 5 equal partitions, right? So we can divide it as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right, children? So each part will show 1/5 of the whole. 5th, 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 5th. Right? So you have to show 3 by 5 means 3/5. So you will take 5th, 5th and 5th. How many times, children? 3 times. So 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 3 times. You will reach here. And this is the number 3 by 5. Right? So this is 3 by 5. If 1/5, 1/5 is taken 2 times, then the second part, this one, will show 2 by 5. And this one, 5th part, 1 times only. This is 1/5, right, children? So it will be written as 1 by 5. Right? After 3 by 5, there will be 4 by 5. Okay, children? And at last, here at point A, you will write 5 by 5. And 5 by 5, 5 1 ja 5 cut, we get 1. So this A shows the one part, the whole part. Right? So this is all that we have discussed in the last class, children. I have told you about numerator and denominator. Numerator is the upper part of the fraction and denominator is the lower part. And all the fractions can be written in the form of A by B. Am I right? A is upper part, that is numerator. B is the lower part, that is the denominator. And A and B both are, children, natural number. Okay, natural numbers are always positive. So A and B both are positive. So if we divide positive integer by positive integer, we will get positive result. That's why I have told children that fractions are always positive, right? So on behalf of this knowledge, now we will start our exercise. Okay, so I request to all to open page number 82 in your RS Agarwal textbook. Okay, here is exercise 5A that you can see on the screen. Question number 1 was given as your homework. Right, children? In this question, we had solved first part of the question yesterday. So let us discuss about the other parts. I hope all of you have solved these questions. In this question, children, see the second part of the figure. In the second part, there is a triangle, as you can see, and this triangle is divided into 4 equal parts. Right, children? Out of these 4 equal parts, you can see one part is shaded. Right? In the same way, in the third part of the question, there is a triangle which is further divided into 3 equal parts. And out of these 3 equal parts, you can see 2 parts are shaded. Right, children? As you can see here, so in the second part, triangle is divided into 4 equal parts. In the third part, triangle is divided into 3 equal parts. So if I ask you what part, what portion of this figure is shaded, so you will say that, sir, here one part is shaded out of total 4 parts, right? So your fraction will be 1 out of 4, right? So this is the way to write this figure in the form of fraction. Clear? In the same way here, the total, the whole figure is divided into how many partitions, children? The whole figure is divided into 1, 2 and 3 equal parts. Am I right? Out of these parts, how many parts are shaded, children? 1 and 2, right? So you will say 2 out of 3. So your fraction will be 2 by 3, right? In the same way, see the next figure, children. In the next figure, there was a box, and this box, this rectangular box, was further divided into how many partitions, children? There are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 partitions. Right, children? Out of these 10 partitions, how many parts are shaded, children? Here you can see this one is shaded, and after that, this one, first, second, and third, 3 parts are shaded, right? So the fraction of shaded part will be 3 out of total, how many parts are there? Total, there are total 10 partitions. So you will write out of 10, right? So this is the way to represent. In the same way, see the next figure. Children, in the next figure, there is a triangle, okay? And this triangle is further divided into number of parts like this. So you can see it here. This is the triangle, children, and this triangle is divided into how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 parts. Total 9 partitions are there. Out of these 9 partitions, how many parts are shaded? Here you can see first part is shaded, then second, third, and fourth. Total 4 parts are shaded. So fraction of shaded part will be 4 out of total 9 partitions are there. So out of 9. So your fraction will be 4 by 9. Right? So in this way, I think all of you have solved these questions. So let us move to the second question from the exercise 5A now. Right, children? So see the question number 2 in your R.S. Agarwal textbook now. So what is question number 2? So in question number 2, set 4 by 9 of the given figure. A figure is given. What is the figure, children? Here you can see a rectangular box is given. And this box is further divided into 9 equal partitions. Am I right? And what part of this box is to be shaded? 4 out of 9. So we have to set the 4 parts out of 9 partitions. So you can see here, there are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, total number 9 partitions are there. And this total number of partitions is represented by the denominator, right? Now numerator tells us about how many parts are to be shaded. So see the numerator. What is the numerator? Numerator is 4, right? So how many parts you will shed, children? You have to shed any 4 parts of the given figure. So you can shed, suppose, 1 part, then second part, and choose any 4 parts. Third part and fourth part, okay? Or you can set 1, 2, 3, 4, any 4 parts you can choose, okay, and set them. So this shaded portion will show 4 by 9 of the whole, right, children? So this is how you have to solve question number 2. Now let us move to question number 3. See question number 3, children. What is question number 3? In this question, there is a figure. Okay, children, look at this figure carefully, and you can see this figure is divided into 4 parts. I am saying 4 parts, not 4 equal parts, right? So you can see here first and second parts, these parts are a little larger, and third and fourth part are very small. Okay, they are smaller. So can we say that each and every part of this figure is showing fourth part of the figure, children? No. Because what is the problem there? In this question, we can see all 4 partitions, all 4 parts are not equal. So each and every part of the figure is not representing 1/4 of the figure. So children, what was the question? Let us discuss now, children. See the question in your book. Question is, in the given figure, if we say that the shaded region is 1/4, then identify the error in it. What is the error? Statement is saying, if we say that shaded region is 1/4, children, is shaded region 1/4? Where is the shaded region, children? This is the shaded region, right, children? So is this shaded region representing 1/4, children? No. Why? This shaded region is not representing 1/4 because all 4 partitions are not equal. This shaded region is not 1/4 of the whole. So what is the error? So we can write, children, shaded region. Question was, in the figure, if we say that shaded region is 1/4, so we will say shaded region is not 1/4 because why it is not equal to 1/4, children? Because each parts are not having equal size. Right, children? So each and every part is having different size. They are not equally divided, right? That's why each part, this shaded part, will not represent 1 by 4. Clear? So let us move to question number 4 now. Right, children? So what is question number 4? Let us see now. The first part, 3/4. Here we have to write a fraction for each of the following. Right, children? So 3/4, a fractional number is given. We have to write the fraction for this. So how can you write, children, 3/4? So 3/4. 3/4 means 3 out of 4. Right? So in fraction we can write it as 3 by 4. Clear, children? In the same way, 4/7, second part, 4/7. So how can we write it, children? We can write it as 4 out of 7. So 4 by 7 is the answer. So simple. Am I right, children? Here 4 is the numerator and 7 is the denominator. Now see the next part, 2/5. So how can we write 2/5, children? 2/5 can be written as 2 out of 5. This is the third part, right? In the same way, fourth part, 3/10. So fourth part is 3/10, right? So 3/10 means 3 out of 10, right? So 3 is numerator, 10 is the denominator. So we can write it as 3 by 10. Clear? It is so simple, children. In the same way, 1/8. So 1/8 can be written as 1/8. Can be written as 1 out of 8. Right? See the sixth part, 5/6. So 5/6 can be written as 5 by 6. Can you do, children? Seventh, 8/9. So 8/9 can be written as 8 by 9. This is the way. So 8/9. And 10th is 7/12. So 7/12 can be written as 7 out of 12. That is 7 by 12. Okay, children? So this is the question. I think this question is clear to you all. So solve this question by yourself. Right? So moving to the next question, children. Question number 5. Here, we have to write down the numerator and denominator of each of the fractions given below. Some fractions are given and you have to tell numerator and denominator. It is so simple, children. See the question number 5. So first part of question number 5 is here 4/9. This is the fraction, children. So what is numerator here, children? Here numerator is 4 and denominator is the lower part of the fraction, right? That means total number of partition. So it is denominator equal to 9. Clear? In the same way, 6/11. Suppose second part is 6/11. So in 6/11, numerator will be 6 and denominator will be 11. It is so simple, right? So the next part, third part, is 8/15. So in 8/15, in third part, fraction is 8/15. So numerator will be 8 and denominator will be 15. Right, children? See the next part, fourth, 12/17. So here numerator is 12, right? And denominator is the lower part, 17th. Clear? So fifth one, 5/1, numerator is 5 and denominator is 1. Clear, children? So this is the question number 5. Now let us move to the next question, that is question number 6. Here, write down the fraction in which numerator is 3 and denominator is 8. In this question, numerator and denominators are given, so we have to write the fraction. In question number 5, fraction was given, we had to write numerator and denominator. Okay. Now in question number 6, numerator and denominator are given, we have to write the fractions. So it is so simple, children. Numerator will be written in the upper part of the fraction, denominator will be written in the lower part of the fraction. Right. So if numerator is 8 and denominator is 15, then fraction will become 8/15. So simple, right? So in the same way, we have to solve question number 6. So let us solve a few part of the question number 6. So 6, first part, see what is the numerator? Here numerator is 3 and denominator is what, children? It is 8, right? So fraction, we have to write the fraction. So fraction will be equal to numerator upon denominator, right, children? So numerator is 3, denominator is 8, so we can write 3/8, right? So in the same way, second part, suppose in the second part, we can see numerator is 5 and denominator is 12. So fraction will be, children, what will be fraction? Fraction will be numerator upon denominator. So we will write 5/12, right? So simple, children. In the same way, see the third part, numerator is 7, denominator is 16. So in the third part, numerator is 7 and denominator is 16, right? So our fraction will be equal to 7/16. Numerator will be written upside and denominator will be written downward. Okay, children? So in the same way, fourth part, numerator 8 and denominator is 15. So what will be fraction, children? Fraction will be 8/15. That means 8/15. Clear? So you can solve this question now. So let us move to the next question now, children. This is question number 7. Here we have to write down the fractional number for each of the following. Right? Fractional number. 2/3 is a fractional. Fraction. Okay. So its fractional number will be 2/3. Okay. 3 is written in the denominator. So it will be written as 3rd. We have chosen 2 parts out of 3 partitions. So each part will represent 3rd part. Okay. So 2/3 will be written as 2/3. It means 3rd part 2 times. Right? So in this way, we have to write the fractional number. So fraction is, here our fraction. What is the fraction, children? It is question number 7. So question number 7, suppose we are solving the first part, right? So see, here our fraction. What is the fraction, children? Fraction is 2/3. Okay? So fractional number, its fractional number will be written as, fractional number will be written as 2/3, that is 2/3. Okay, so 3rd part will be taken 2 times, right, children? So write it here, 2/3. Clear? In the same way, see the next part, second part of the question, 4/9. In second part, fraction is 4/9. Now 4/9. So we have made total 9 partitions. So each part will show the 9th part, and 9th part is taken how many times? 4 times. Okay. So it will be written as 4/9. Okay. 4/9. Right, children? In the same way, see the next part of the question, children. The next part is 2/5. Suppose 3rd part, our fraction is 2/5. This is the fraction, children, 2/5. So we have made total 5 partition. So each part will be equal to 5th part. Okay. And 5th part is taken 2 times. So we will write it as 2/5. This is the fractional number. Clear, children? Let us solve one more part of the same question, children. Suppose fourth part. Let us see fourth part. So fourth part is 7/10. Okay. We have made total 10 partitions, so each part will be 10th part, dasva hissa, right? And 10th part is taken 7 times, okay? So we can write it as 7/10. Right, children? So this is the way to write the fractional number. Fraction is given, we have to write its fractional number. So, see the fifth part, 1/3. So 1/3 can be written as 1/3, right? Then sixth part, 3/4. So children, 3/4 can be written as 3/4, right? So 3/4 can be written as 3/4. It means fourth part is taken 3 times. Okay, children? In the same way, next 3/8. So 3/8, we have made total 8 partitions, so each part will be equal to 8th part, okay? 8th part is taken 3 times, so we will say it as 3/8, okay? This is the way. So 9/14 can be written as 9/14th, right? 5/11 can be written as 5/11th part, that means. Okay, children? So 6/15 can be written as 6/15th. Okay, put th at last. So 15th. Clear? So this is the way to write. It was question number 7. I think this question is clear to you all, children. So let us move to the next question, that is question number 8. What is question number 8, children? See the question, children. What fraction of an hour? What fraction of an hour is 24 minutes? Okay, okay, children. So total time is 1 hour. Okay. Right? And time chosen. We have to find the fraction of fraction of 24 minute. We have to find what part of 1 hour is 24 minute. Right, children? So total time, total parts is 1 hour. And the part, the time that we have chosen is 24 minutes. So we have to find what part of 1 hour is 24 minute. Okay, that is our part. Right, children? So here time is given in hour. And here time is given in minutes. So first thing that we will do is that convert hour into minutes. So children, how many minutes are there in 1 hour, children? There are 60 minutes, right? So firstly convert 1 hour into minute, right? So 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. Clear? Now we have to find out what part of 60 minutes is 24 minutes. Okay, so we have to choose 24 minutes out of 60 minutes, right? So 24 will be written upside, that is the total number of chosen parts, and 60 minutes, total time, total number of partitions will be written in the lower part, that is in denominator, right? So 24 out of 60, that is our fraction, right, children? So required fraction. Will be equal to 24 minute divided by total time. Total time, total number of partition is 60 minutes, right? And out of this 60 minutes, we have chosen 24 minutes for us. And we have to find what part of this 64 is 24 minutes. So 24 minutes is taken out of 60 minutes, right? So minute and minute will be cancelled. Clear, children? So we get 24/60, right? 24 and 60 both are having a common factor, that is 12. 24 can be written as 12 into 2, and 60 can be written as 12 into 5. Right, children? So 12 is the highest common factor of 12, 24 and 16, right? So we can cancel this 12 and 12. Okay, children? So what do we get? We get 2 by 5. So we can write it as 2 by 5. So we will cut both the numbers 24 and 60 by 12. So 24 to the 12 to the 24 and 12 5 the 60. So we get 2 by 5. That means 24 minute is 2 by 5th part of 1 hour, children. Right? So this is how we have to solve this question, children. Clear? So total time that we have chosen will be written in the numerator and total time will be written in denominator. Okay, time chosen by us will be written in numerator, total time will be written in denominator. So we have chosen 24 minutes, so we will write it in numerator, and total time 60 minutes will be written in denominator. Then divide, minute will be cancelled, and you will cut by 12 and get 2 by 5. This is the way. Clear? So now let us move to the next question, children. That is question number 9. Children, read the question number 9, all of you. I think all of you are having book, so you can read the questions in your book. So children, what is the question? How many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10? Okay? And what fraction of them are prime numbers? How many natural numbers from 2 to 10? Question number 9. So natural numbers starting from 2 to 10. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Right, children? Question is asking how many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10. So you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? So number of naturals is from 2 to 10 is equal to 9. Right? This is the first part of the question. How many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10? So you will say that there are total 9 natural numbers excluding 1. 1 is not to be counted. Okay. So we will start from 2 to 10. So there will be total 9 natural numbers. Now, what is the next part of the question, children? What fraction of them are prime numbers? Okay. So out of these numbers, children, find out which are the prime numbers. Do you remember what are the prime numbers? In the second chapter, factors and multiples, we had discussed about prime numbers, right? So prime numbers are the numbers which are divisible by themselves, which have only two common factors. First is the number itself and second one is the 1. Right, children? So prime numbers, here you can see 2 can be divided by 2 only. Okay, 3 can be divided by 3 only, right? So 2 and 3 are prime numbers. 4 is having three factors, that is 1, 2 and 4. It is divisible by 1, 2 and 4. So it is having three factors, right? So 4 is not a prime number. Clear, children? So prime numbers here are 2, then 3. 4 is not a prime number, this is a composite number. Then 5. 5 is a prime number, right? Then 6. 6 is having 4 factors, 1, 2, 3 and 6. It is divisible by 1, 2 and 3 and 6. Okay, so it is having 4 factors. Prime numbers have only 2 factors. Okay, children? So 6 is a composite number. Then 7. 7 is divisible by 7 only and by 1 also. So it has only 2 factors, 7 and 1. So 7 is a prime number. Then 8. 8 is a composite number because it is having 1, 2, 4 and 8, total 4 factors. Okay, it can be divided by 4 numbers. So 8 is a composite number. 9 again is a composite number because it is divisible by 1, 3 and 9. So it is having 3 factors, right? After that, 10 is a composite number. It is divisible by 1, 2, 5 and 10. So what prime numbers are here? Here prime
numbers. Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5 and 7.
Okay? Question is asking, what fractions of this natural number is prime number? So here are total 9 natural numbers. We have to find the fraction of prime numbers. So firstly, we will have to see how many numbers are prime numbers here, children. Here you can see there are 1, 2, 3 and 4 prime numbers, right? So number of primes is 4, right, children? Number of primes is 4. So out of these 9 natural numbers, there are 4 numbers which are prime. So what is the fraction of prime numbers, children? So fraction of prime. So prime numbers, total partition is 9, total number are 9, and out of these 9, how many primes are there? 4. So we will say that fraction of prime number is 4 out of 9, right? So we can write it as 4 divided by 9. So this is the answer, children. So question was, what fraction of natural numbers from 2 to 10 is prime? So firstly, we will see total how many natural numbers are there starting from 2 to 10. So there are total 9 natural numbers. Okay. After that, we will see out of these 9 natural numbers, how many natural numbers are prime. So we can see here, children, there are 2, 3, 5 and 7, total 4 prime numbers. We have to tell about the fraction of these prime numbers. What fraction of total 9 natural numbers is of prime number? Okay, so out of this 9, we can see there are 4 prime numbers. So fraction of prime numbers starting from 2 to 10 is 4 out of 9, that is 4 by 9, right, children? So this is the question number, it was question number, children, 9, right? So children, this is all for today. From tomorrow, we will start question number 10. Okay, so we'll discuss the remaining question in the next class. So children, till then, stay safe and stay at home. Okay, children, thank you and Jai Hind.